Hi everyone, welcome back to my YouTube videos. In this video, I'm going to solve exercises 2.18 and 2.20 of the textbook, First Course in Probability. The reason why I'm going to do both primes in the same video is because they are both related and they are both about blackjack. So the first prime, 2.18, is about just computing the probability of having a blackjack. And what you have to know here is that you play blackjack with exactly like poker, an ordinary deck of 52 cards, and instead of taking 5 cards, you take only 2. And a blackjack is basically the combination of an ace. So you need an ace to have a blackjack. One of the 4 aces is good enough, and you need also one of those 4 denominations. 10, Jack, Queen, or King. So that gives you another set of 16 cards to choose from. And so what we mean by a blackjack is basically any of, let's say, those 4. So let me take this one, for instance. So we have the Jack and an Ace. So that's, for instance, a blackjack. So to compute the probability of a blackjack, we use basically same technique as for poker probabilities, but it's in fact even easier because we take only 2 cards. I mean, things are like smaller. And so we can conclude that for the first prime, the probability of a blackjack, so it's going to be equal because we are again in the setting of symmetric probability spaces. We assume that, of course, the deck of 52 cards is well mixed. So any 2 cards that you can choose, I mean, you have like all the possible ways you can take any 2 cards are equally likely. And so that means that the probability of a blackjack is just going to be equal to the total number of blackjacks divided by the total number of ways you can take 2 cards from a deck of 52. The number of blackjacks is very easy to compute. It's just you need an ace, so that means 4 possibilities, and then you need either a 10 or a jack, a queen or a king. That gives you 4 times 4 equals 16 possible cards, 4 denominations times 4 suits. So the total number of blackjacks is simply equal to 4 times 16. So this is equal to 4 times 16, number of blackjacks divided by 52 choose 2, number of ways you can take 2 cards from a set of 52 cards. And so if you use a calculator to compute this explicitly, you will find that this probability is about equal to 0.04827. That means that you get a blackjack a little bit less than 5% of the time. So now let's move on to prime 2.20. So in 2.20, we assume now that we have 2 players instead of 1. Each player is going to take 2 cards from the deck of 52, and the goal is to compute the probability that none of the 2 players has a blackjack. So you might think at first that, well, the probability that 2 players don't have a blackjack is just, well, the probability of not having a blackjack, that's 1 minus this, and you look at the square of that, okay, just to get the probability that none of the 2 players has a blackjack. Be careful, that's wrong. That would be exactly the probability of not having a blackjack twice in a row. If you take 2 cards, look at the 2 cards, put them back, mix again the deck, and then take another 2 cards. Here, things are different. You don't take 2 cards from a deck of 52 twice in a row. You take 2 cards from a deck of 52, and then another 2 cards from the remaining 50 cards. So that's not exactly the probability of not having a blackjack square. So to solve this problem, instead of dealing with this weird event saying that player 1 doesn't have a blackjack and player 2 doesn't have a blackjack, we are going to instead introduce more like simpler event, elementary events. Let's say A1, A2, the event that that player 1 has a blackjack, and A2 is going to be the event that player 2 has a blackjack, and then we can re-express our event using those 2 like elementary events. So that's the first step. So for 220, the first step is, for instance, you can call AI the event that player I has a blackjack. So player I has a blackjack. Then the event we are interested in is event that none of the two players has a blackjack. So that means that player one doesn't have a blackjack, that's A1 complement. Player two doesn't have a blackjack, that's A2 complement. You want both events to occur, so that's going to be the intersection of the two complements. And so what we want to look at is the probability of A1 complement intersection A2 complement. Okay, so now we have our event of interest. Now we know, of course, from this previous poem that P of A1 and P of A2 are both equal to that number. And so the idea is going to be kind of to try to re-express this event, but using only A1, A2, okay? And so now the idea is just to say that saying that none of the two players has a blackjack, so intersection of the complement, should be equal to the complement of the union, okay? So you can rewrite this and say that this is the probability of, let's say, A1 union, A2 complement. Okay, so now what I'm trying to do is try to force our A1 and A2, okay, and get rid of the complement here. Then next step, well, because in the probability of the complement of an event is just 1 minus the probability of this event. Now you can just rewrite this and say that this is 1 minus the probability of A1 union A2. Alright, so we have this. And then because, well, those two events are not mutually exclusive, it's possible that both players have a blackjack, so P of A1 intersection A2 is not, I mean, A1 intersection A2, I should say, is not the empty set. So we need to take that into account. And here we are going to use like a particular case of the inclusion exclusion identity, but with only two events. So what's going on is, I can draw a picture here, is that you have the two events here, A1 and A2. We start by looking at probability that none of the two players has a blackjack, so we are outside here. We are looking at basically this event here. So that's exactly the event of interest, okay? And so step one, we say that this event is also the complement of the union that's equal to 1 minus the probability of the union. And now I'm going to say that the probability of the union is the probability of A1 plus the probability of A2. But if I do this, I overestimate the probability of the intersection here. So I need to remove, to subtract by probability of the intersection. And so eventually you get that this is 1 minus P of A1. Or let me write that under to have space. So that's equal to 1 minus P of A1 minus P of A2 and then plus P of A1 intersection A2. Okay, so again, this is just the inclusion-exclusion identity in the particular case of only two events. So the goal is just to compute this. Now we know almost everything. We know P of A1, P of A2, they are both equal to that number, but we still need to compute this one. For this one, things are a little bit more difficult. You have to have in mind that the sample space attached to this event, because now you have two players, you look at like player one and player two both have a blackjack, that's this event. The size of the sample space, the total number of outcomes, is not equal to just 52 choose 2. You need to take two cards from the deck and another two cards from the remaining 50. So the size of the sample space attached to this event attached to the experiment that you have now two players is going to be exactly 52 choose 2 times 50 choose 2. Okay? So you don't just take two cards, or you don't take also like just four cards. You take two cards for one player and then another two cards for the other player from the remaining 50 cards. So we need to compute this. So now we need to use this also. Now we can conclude that the probability that we are looking for is going to be equal. So for the next question, so we started with probability of, we said A1 complement, intersection A2 complement, none of them has a blackjack, is going to be equal to 1 minus 2 times that number, so minus 2 times 4 times 16 divided by 52 choose 2. Then last step, to compute this probability, so what we need is have a blackjack for the first player, that's again this probability, but multiply by something a little bit different, so that's going to be a plus 4 times 16 divided by 52 choose 2. But then the probability that also the second player has a blackjack is going to be now after the first player has a blackjack, there is only three aces left in the deck of cards, and there are only 15 instead of those 16 cards, there are only 15 remaining such cards, like either 10, jack, queen or king. And so that means that we need to multiply this by 3 times 15. Okay, that's the total number of remaining, like let's say pairs of cards form a blackjack if there is already like one ace taken from the deck and one either 10, jack, queen or king. So that's the total number of blackjack left in the deck. And then you need to divide this by, this time, 50 choose 2, because there are only 50 cards left after the first player took the blackjack. So again, that's the probability of having a blackjack, that's about equal to 0.04827. This one, again, if you just compute this explicitly, you would find that if you have two players playing blackjack, the two players take each two cards, the probability that none of them has a blackjack is about equal to 0.9052. So that's a little bit over 90% of the time that this happens.